We have to change the status quo so that driving while black doesn't result in getting shot. There's a photo of your son, of Dante, that many Americans have seen by now. He's standing outdoors on a sparkling day, holding his son, Dante Jr., and he's got this big smile on his face, that smile that you said, Katie, would light up the room. We see the lively, outgoing young man who always made people laugh, who was lovingly voted class clown his freshman year by his high school class. We see the basketball fan whose left-handed shot would make any coach proud. Most of all, we see Dante's radiant love for his family as he holds his baby boy. In the photo, Dante Jr. wears a colorful bib with polka dots and a bow tie, and the words "first birthday" printed in cheerful letters across the front. And that's when we see the enormous hole Dante leaves in the world. That's when we remember that he won't be there for his son's second birthday or high school graduation or to see those grandkids. Racism in this country is not isolated, it is systemic. And so, when we ask ourselves why Dante Jr. has to grow up without a dad, when we think about what could possibly fill this hole Dante left in the world, we come up empty. Instead, we find a much bigger hole where justice should be. We cannot confuse accountability for justice, because true justice is not done as long as having expired tags means losing your life during a traffic stop. True justice is not done as long as a chokehold, a knee on the neck, or a no-knock warrant is considered legitimate policing. True justice is not done as long as black Americans are killed by law enforcement at more than twice the rate of white Americans. And to use your words, Katie, true justice is not done as long as your son isn't coming home for dinner. Our hearts ache for Dante in part because so many people in this room and throughout our state can imagine being 20 years old, driving around their neighborhood on a Sunday afternoon. Yes, even with expired registration tags. Yes, even with an air freshener hanging from the rearview mirror. Many young people can imagine calling their mom when they need insurance information or when they're scared, but only some can imagine being shot by a police officer during a traffic stop. Only some could imagine that this phone call would be their last. Only some live with that fear every single day. And that, Mr. Crump, as you know, is the definition of injustice. It is on us as leaders in our communities, in our neighborhoods, as lawmakers. We can do more, we must do more, because for too long change has come inch by inch when we should be miles ahead. It is time for Washington, D.C. to move forward on police reform and pass the George Floyd Justice in Policing Act. We must make policing more accountable. We have to change police training and standards, including banning chokeholds, which my colleague, Senator Smith, is leading the bill to ban chokeholds, along with myself. She is up here with me on this stage. We have to change the status quo so that driving while black doesn't result in getting shot. This is the urgent task before us, not for tomorrow when I go back to Washington, not for tomorrow. Not for next year, but for now. True justice. So as we remember Dante's life and grieve his death, we must repair what's broken in this country and make sure class clowns and basketball fans, doting fathers and caring sons, remain with us in body, as Dante now does in spirit, Mrs. Wright. And we won't rest until justice, true justice, is done.
No words can really help ease the pain, No words can really help to ease the loss you bear. Just know that your family and friends are very close in every thought and prayer. May the outpouring of sympathy, the kinds of acts of friends and strangers, the comfort in knowing that your loss is felt by many, help you through this. Dante Demetrius Wright brought great joy to his family, and his life was a blessing to all who had the privilege to know him. We also wanted to present this to his mom and dad, if you all can come. We flew a flag over the United States Capitol on behalf of your son. And I wanted to present the flag to you.